Hi, welcome to our sample test questions for the Utah Driver License Written Test. This is created by the nonprofit Advocates for Refugees. Donations needed. You can go to advocatesforrefugees.org. So, Section 7, this is Section 7 in the Driver's Handbook, Rules of the Road, page 17. So this is under the section yielding right of way. So question one, who should you let go first when you arrive at an intersection at the same time? Answer, the driver on your right at a four-way stop. Question two, when must you yield the right of way to drivers in the opposite lane? When must you yield the right of way to drivers in the opposite lane? Answer, when you are making a left turn. Question three, what should you do when you are entering an interstate highway from an entrance ramp? What should you do when you are entering an interstate highway from an entrance ramp? Answer, yield to drivers already on the interstate highway. Question four, what is the key factor when deciding who has the right of way? The key factor when deciding who has the right of way. Answer, your own safety is the key factor. Question five, when is it necessary to yield the right of way to pedestrians, bicyclists, and others? Answer, when they are still in the intersection. So it's not just when they're still in the intersection, it is when they are standing there at the corner, you need to stop and allow them, you know, at a crosswalk or at any corner, you need to stop and allow them to proceed. So question six, why is it important to yield the right of way to a driver who arrived at the intersection before you? You know, courtesy and safety, and that's the rule, that's the law. Question seven, who do you yield the right of way to if you are coming from a driveway onto a public road? Answer, drivers on the public road. Question eight, what should you always consider even if you think you have the right of way? Answer, the situation and your own safety. What should you do when you want to make a left turn and drivers are coming from the opposite lane? Answer, yield the right of way to the drivers in the opposite lane. Just go back, if you're making a left turn and drivers are coming from the opposite lane, you need to yield to them because you're making a left turn. That's just the rule. If you're making a left turn, you know, you need to stop. When I say yield, you need to stop and allow them to continue. You just can't be driving in front of cars that are coming from the opposite lane. Yield the right of way to drivers in the opposite lane. I hope we can understand that. Question 10, what is the main rule of right of way? Answer, never assume you have the right of way. Always consider the situation and your safety. Sometimes you know you have the right of way, but somebody's coming anyway, you let somebody go, even if you're in the right You don't want to be dead and have the right of way, you know, exercise your right of way. You just need to allow someone else, some other sometimes crazy driver, the right of way, even though you deserve it. Just be very careful and allow them to go. Okay, now we're talking about traffic controls. Question one, where are traffic lights usually found? Answer, at intersections. It's usually at intersections. Not always. They might just be not at intersections, at a crosswalk, for example. Question two, what does a horizontal traffic light look like, and where is each colored light located? Answer, red light on the left, yellow light in the middle, and green light on the right. Question three, what does a flashing yellow traffic light mean? What does a flashing yellow traffic light mean? Answer, slow down and proceed with caution. Be prepared to stop for any traffic. Question four, when can you make a right turn on a red light? When can you make a right turn on a red light? Answer, after coming to a full and complete stop, unless posted otherwise. If it's a left turn, the answer is completely different. Okay, so we're just talking about the right turn. Question five, what does a red traffic light mean? It says you must stop before entering the intersection. Well, you must stop and wait. So in the next line, it says you must wait behind the stop line. It's not just stopping before entering. You must stop and wait. Wait behind the stop line, a crosswalk or intersection until the light turns green. You may make a right turn on a red light after coming to a full and complete stop unless posted otherwise. So, stop and wait behind the stop line, okay? Okay, question six, what should you do at a flashing red traffic light? Answer, stop and look both ways before entering the intersection. Question seven, when is it allowed to make a left turn on a red arrow light? When is it allowed to make a left turn on a red arrow light? Answer, when you are on a one-way street turning onto another one-way street. Question eight, what does a green arrow light mean? What does a green arrow light mean? Answer, vehicles may proceed only in the direction of the arrow. After yielding to vehicles and pedestrians still in the intersection. Question nine, what should you do when you see a yellow traffic light? What should you do when you see a yellow traffic light? Answer, be prepared for the light to change to red. Yellow means be prepared for the light to change to red. When I say be prepared, slow down. I mean, if you can slow down and stop, then do that. because the light's going to turn red. Don't be speeding up. Don't be speeding up and try to beat the red light. I mean, and get there. If you've got enough time to stop, stop. That way you'll live and other people will live. Question 10, what should you do at a flashing yellow arrow light and oncoming traffic has a green light? Answer, yield to oncoming traffic and pedestrians before making a turn. Okay, that's it for now for this video. There are a lot more questions. We'll see how this works. Enjoy, good luck, pass that test. See if you can read that handbook.